Well, hello there, you're watching the official Theme Park Fans YouTube channel, and welcome to the Scarefest 2023 opening day vlog. Now, it's been a while since I've last vlogged at Alton Towers. In fact, I think the last time I vlogged here at Alton Towers was for the first day of the season, which is absolutely crazy when you think about it. Obviously, I didn't get to do a Mardi Gras vlog. I didn't get to do an Oktoberfest vlog, which is really surprising, considering that Oktoberfest is my favourite event here at Alton Towers. And of course, I didn't get to do the annual Scarefest preview video that I do for you guys. But yeah, anyway, so Scarefest is back once again for another year. It's the 16th year of Scarefest, which is amazing when you think about it. And yeah, it's great that Scarefest is back. I mean, I'm not too excited about the maze lineup personally, but I'm sure once I get to do them, I'm sure I'll get into the groove of things. And yeah, so it'd be nice to try out the scare mazes. So you've got Darkest Depths, you've got the Attic, you've got Altonville, which has been changed to Altonville, Mind Tools, Tiny's Revenge, and then you've got, yeah, the Invitation. The less said about the Invitation, the better. So yeah, that'd be good. And it'd also be nice to do some rides in the dark. That would be very good. You know, I love doing rides in the dark, you know, especially Wicker Man. You know, I love Wicker Man in the dark. So yeah, Scarefest, it's back. And yeah, let's go and have a spooky day here at Scarefest 2023. I'm Will Donahue, you watch Theme Park Fans, and it's time to open that intro. Spooky season is well and truly here. So we've just done our first two rides of the day here at Alton Towers for the first day of Scarefest 2023. And our first two rides were Oblivion and Spin Jam. My dad's having a quick ride on Twistatron. I don't really like Twistatron because I find the seats and the restraints too uncomfortable. So I'm giving it a miss. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of Twistatron. I'm not sure where we're going to head to next, but it's been a great start to the day. You know, when we got to X Sector, our initial plan was to ride the Smiler first, but then in the distance we could see that Oblivion was pretty much a walk-on, so we opted to go on Oblivion instead. And after Oblivion, we went over to Spin Jam, and again, you know, that was virtually a walk-on as well. I think it's the same with Twistatron as well. I believe that's a walk-on. So I don't know where we're going to head to next. I think we might potentially do the Smiler, using a single rider queue, and then I'm not sure what we'll do after that. But we do have Fast Track for today, so that'll be good. I think we are going to use some of our Fast Track for later on in the day when it gets dark. So nighttime rides, I'm really looking forward to that. And whilst we are on the subject of nighttime rides, leave a comment below. What is your favourite ride? What is your favourite ride to do in the dark here at Alton Towers? I would love to know all of your opinions. So get commenting below about what is your favourite ride to do here at Alton Towers in the dark. And yeah, what a great start to our day here, at Alton Towers for the first day of Scarefest 2023. So we had a ride on the Smiler and used as a single rider queue, and we were literally on within 5 minutes, and me and my dad, we got to ride together, so that was an added bonus. It's very rare that happens when you get put together with someone, you know, when you're both waiting in a single rider queue, but no, it was a nice added bonus. I think our plan of action now is to head down to the Curse of Alton Manor, have a ride on the Curse, visit Emily Alton in her spooky gaff, and I think later on tonight, I think we're going to head down to the Lawns and watch the Ancestors, the Alton Ancestors. They've got a show on at 6 o'clock, so that should be good. And when we do go and watch the Alton ancestors on the stage, I'll get a bit of footage for you guys. And it's time to go and visit Emily Alton again. I mean, how many times has Emily Alton invited me over for the New Year's party? I mean, I love it. You know, Emily Alton is a good friend of mine. but yeah, let's go and visit Emily Alton, and then we'll see where we head to next after that. So we did the Curse of Alton Manor, and just then we had a ride on Nemesis of Terror. The Curse of Alton Manor was great, and there are some new effects in the ride. There's a smoke around the queue line, and in the ride there's new effects. There's projection mapping in the like hide and seek area of the dark ride. And there's a lot more projection mapping inside the Curse of Alton Manor. And you know, I really like how Towers are adding more effects to the Curse of Alton Manor. I just hope that Towers can maintain the effects over the year, over the years. You know, it'd be really good if they can, you know, maintain the effects of the maintain the effects inside the dark ride. Subterra, that was good. I don't think because obviously, as I said at the start of this vlog, I think the only vlog I've done that tells this year was the one from the first day of the season. So yeah, Subterra, it's nice to have it back. You know, I personally still can't believe it's back after all these years. You know, I thought we'd never see Subterra again, but it's back. It's an enjoyable experience, and I do hope that Towers keep Subterra open for next year, and even beyond next year. You know, because I think it would be pointless if they closed it next year, or you know, if they kept it open next year and then closed it for 2025. You know, I think that'd be a bit pointless. So here's hoping they do keep Subterra open for literally for the foreseeable future, for many years to come. We're just stopping for some lunch now. I've got myself a sausage roll, of course, and a bag of crisps, so I'm going to be tucking into those shortly. After that, I'm not sure what we're going to go to next, but it will soon be time to do the scare mazes. We have booked our scare mazes for 2:30, so that'll be coming up soon. And yeah, enjoying our day here for the first day of Scarefest 2023. So after some lunch, we've decided to come up to the Nemesis observation platform. Now, the last time I showed you guys this view was back in April. Nothing was on the site of Nemesis, but now just look at it. It's nearly completed, guys. I cannot believe how fast Towers have done with this retrack work for Nemesis. As you can see there, the station colour has changed a bit. You can see as well the entrance for Nemesis, that's been painted black.
Lab 9005901130003. Scientific testing is in progress at this site.
I cannot wait to get back on Nemesis next year. It's going to be amazing, isn't it, guys? It's going to be absolutely incredible. My Nemesis is reborn next year. So we've just had a good ride on Wicker Man. Before that, we were going to have another ride on the Curse of Alton Manor, but sadly that went down, so we didn't get to do it for a second time. Now we're heading over to do our scare mazes. We've booked the scare mazes for 2:30. And we're going to start off on the invitation first, you know. Just getting that one out of the way. You know, you guys already know my thoughts on the invitation. So yeah, we're gonna do the invitation first. And I'm not sure what we're gonna do in terms of the other three mazes, like in what order, but I guess we'll figure it out. So I'll see you guys once we've done all four mazes. I mean, the invitation's not really a maze, but you get what I mean, don't you? So we've just done all four scare attractions. I say scare attractions because the invitation really isn't a scare maze. So we first did the invitation, then we did Dark Steps, then we did the Attic, and then we did Altonville Mind Tools Tiny's Revenge. I'm not going to go into too much detail because I'm going to probably do a separate video where I'll go further in depth with my thoughts on the scare attractions. But let's just say out of all of them, I probably enjoyed Altonville the most and then Invitation the least. But again, I'll go further. I'll review the scare attractions further when I make a separate video for them. By the way, yeah, it's good to do all four scare attractions. You know, I mean, that's me saying something about the Invitation. And yeah, I think we're going to head over to Rita next as our next ride, because we do have a Silver Fast Track. Yeah, that's about it. All four scare attractions done. Now it's time for the next ride. So after we did the four scare attractions, we had a ride on Rita, which was pretty decent. We were then going to have a ride on Gangster Granny, but the queue for Gangster Granny looked quite big. So instead, we decided to go to Corner Coffee, and I got myself a sandwich and a bag of crisps. I've already had the sandwich. And just a couple of minutes ago, I've decided to treat myself to a, you know what's coming, a beer. But it's not just any beer, it's the Laugh and Scream Lager that's been brewed exclusively for Alton Towers from the local rural brewing company in Alton, which I think it's good that they brewed a beer for Towers, you know, and it's really nice as well. When I was queuing up to get my pint, I noticed one of the people who were working behind the bar, they took off the Spartan logo on the, you know, on the taps. So you know when, obviously, you know, you go to a pub or bar and they have like the beers like on like a circle disc thing, and I saw them taking the Spartan off, and I was just, my heart sank. But no, it's good to have the Laugh and Scream Lager. Cheers to that. I think we're going to wait for the Alton Ancestor show, which is going to begin in under an hour. And after that, I think we're going to... where are we going to head to after that? We're going to head back to Rita. Because we've got a backtrack for that at 7 o'clock. Then we're going to do 13. Then we're going to do Smiler, Oblivion, and then I can't believe I'm saying this, but to end off the day, we're doing Galactica. It's the last ride of the day.
And we're doing Wicker
Man. Oh, and Wicker.
In the dark.
And Wicker, Wicker Man before that. So probably, let me do that again. So, Vita first, then 13, then Wicker Man, then Oblivion, Smiler, and then Galactica. There we go. Got it spot on. And yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit.
Just come along for the ride. Oh, my heart is so tight. You can see my heart.
The ancestors of the front lawns, and I must say they were really good. However, the show was a bit short, it was only around 10 minutes long. I thought it would have been longer, but nonetheless, it was still good. We've just been down to the Dark Towers, and we had a nighttime man on 13 and a nighttime man on Rita. Our next plan of action is we're gonna head down to Wicker Man and get that done, and then get Smiler and a Blimmin done, hopefully, and then down to Forbidden Valley to do Galactica. But yeah, I always enjoy a nighttime one on 13. You know, I love 13 in the dark, I love Oblivion in the dark, and I love Wicker Man in the dark. And of course, I do love Nemesis in the dark. But Nemesis, it's still going through its retrack work, isn't it? So this time next year, we'll be back on Nemesis in the dark, won't we? Which I'm looking forward to. So yeah, let's head down to Wicker Man, shall we? So we've just done Wicker Man in the dark, which was great. And we've just been through the new Scare Zone, which is themed around Wicker Man, Burial Grounds. And I'd say I really enjoyed it. There was one section where you go through like this tent, and I couldn't see where I was going. I was so disorientated, like literally, there was so much fog in that section. I literally could not see where I was going, it was crazy. But yeah, Burial Grounds, I have to say it's a great addition to Scarefest, and I'm really delighted that Towers have brought back a Scare Zone in some sense, and I think for future Scarefests, does that even make sense, Scarefests? But anyway, you know what I mean. But shall we say for the future, that's better. So I think for the future, I think Towers should do more Scare Zones. I mean, the possibilities are endless. Like, you could have a Scare Zone in X Sector, themed to, I don't know, Smiler maybe, Oblivion. I mean, let's not forget, back in 2015, you had a Scare Zone in Forbidden Valley. Called Dark Apocalypse, which was pretty much themed around Nemesis. And then you had Nox and Vernus in Dark Forest, which that was themed to 13. So I really do think Towers should bring back more Scare Zones for the future. Anyway, we're going to head over to X Sector now and have a nighttime ride on the Smiler. So we've had a ride on the Smiler, and we were on the second row. We could have been on the front row, but you couldn't invite it. So when we were waiting to get on, we saw two people in front of us, and we were thinking, oh yes, front row, yay. No. So basically, there was a single rider in front of us, and I didn't know until like the last few moments, and honestly, I was just gutted. I was I was absolutely gutted. But yeah, inside I was fuming. No, I wasn't really. Anyway, we're gonna head over to Forbidden Valley to have our last ride of the day on Galactica. It's a bit weird finishing on Galactica. I mean, out of all the coasters here, like to finish on Galactica is a bit weird, but yeah. We were gonna do Oblivion, but like, if we did Oblivion, even with our silver fast tracks, we wouldn't really have time to like get all the way over to Forbidden Valley from X-Sector. So we've decided to do Galactica because we did Oblivion earlier in the day anyway. So yeah, let's head over to Galactica for our final ride of the day. Well, 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 it's the day after the first day of Scarefest 2023. We ended our day yesterday with a ride of Galactica, and the reason why I didn't vlog after we did Galactica was because I was just so tired, and you know, we got back home pretty late, and even when we did get back home, I had a couple of beers, and I didn't even go to bed until like close enough to 2 in the morning. You know, I was just so shattered. Like, after we did Galactica, I felt like I couldn't vlog anymore. I was just so tired. But yeah, it was a great day yesterday for the first day of Scarefest 2023. It was really, really good day. We got on a lot of rides. I mean, that was purely down to the fast track. But no, it was a great day, and you know, it was good to experience all the scare attractions. Well, maybe not the invitation, but yeah. But anyway, guys, that is it for another vlog. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you did, then please hit the like button because it really helps the channel out. If you are new around here and you would like to become part of the Theme Park Fans family, then be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss a single video. Don't forget to check out our Facebook page. As always, our Facebook page link is in the description below, so please go and check that out and give it a like. The next video, I will be doing my Scarefest in-depth thoughts on the full scare attractions. So that should be good. And I think I'm going to look at doing a POV video of Burial Grounds, because Burial Grounds, you can film in there. The reason why I didn't film originally, because I thought it wouldn't be allowed, you know, because obviously in the mazes, you can't film, but in Burial Grounds you can. So I think I'll look to get a POV of Burial Grounds for you guys, because I think I'm going to be going back to Scarefest again on Friday, after I finish work, which, I mean, it's an added bonus, isn't it? So I'll look to do a POV video of Burial Grounds for you guys, so in case if you aren't going to Scarefest this year, then you can see what Burial Grounds looks like. Anyway, that's it for another vlog. I'm Will Donu, you've watched Theme Park Fans, and it's time to close the video down. Bye guys, I'll see you soon for the next video.